Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. We're going to talk about the nucleophiles that you tend to encounter in SN2 reactions. And we won't cover all of them, but we'll just cover the most common ones. So we know for an SN2 reaction, you must have a good nucleophile, but we haven't identified what these nucleophiles are. Nucleophiles are nucleus-loving. That's what nucleophile means. So all nucleophiles are going to be electron-rich. How can you tell if something's electron-rich? Almost always a good nucleophile that's electron-rich will be an anion. So any anion is a potential nucleophile for us to consider for an SN2 reaction. Not all anions are, but a whole lot of them are. So what are the great nucleophiles? The great nucleophiles are in this column on the left. They include azide, which is N3, kind of an odd anion, but that is a fantastic SN2 nucleophile. They include cyanide, just an incredibly good nucleophile, and sulfides. And these are probably less common in organic chemistry, but R could be anything. R could be methyl, R could be ethyl, but these are all in a category called sulfides, and they have a sulfur anion, and that makes them a really good, strong nucleophile. Anytime you see these, the great nucleophiles, the person using them almost certainly wants to do an SN2 reaction. So it's almost kind of an automatic at that point. If you're using that, it's almost certainly intended as an SN2 reaction. So there are other nucleophiles that are not the great nucleophiles. These are simply good nucleophiles. Really common ones for us and for organic chemistry students include hydroxide, nice anion, and alkoxides. So these are all alkoxides, also have an O-, but the other side of the oxygen is bonded to a carbon group. Could be methyl, could be ethyl, you name it. But those are all called alkoxides, alkyl oxides. Now there are others. Amines are sometimes used in SN2 reactions. Note that this is a little different. The nitrogen has a lone pair, so it is electron rich, but it doesn't trigger this anion category. However, it's still electron rich enough to act as a nucleophile. Two other weird ones that are very commonly encountered are bromide and iodide, and these are at the bottom. These are anions that we also consider to be good leaving groups because they're halides. So that's kind of a weird thing. Can the leaving group also be a nucleophile? And the answer is yes, especially in the cases of bromide and iodide. There are other less common nucleophiles, but that we will see later and that you'll often see in a first semester or second semester course. The acetylides, this is an sp3 hybridized carbon with an anion. Those are actually pretty nucleophilic. Things called enolates, which we'll encounter later, I wouldn't worry too much about them. I'm just putting them here so that when they show up later, I can say, I told you so, to be completely honest. But we won't encounter these for a little while. And reagents called phosphines. And these normally show up in the second semester of an organic chemistry class. So here are nucleophiles. I'm going to throw one more idea at you. These nucleophiles that are anions, most of these that are in this middle column, and in fact on the right, these are good anions, they're good nucleophiles, but they're also a little bit basic. And basic nucleophiles do other things, like they do what bases do. They want to deprotonate stuff instead of attacking in an SN2 reaction. So I'm kind of foreshadowing what we might see later on. But these on this side tend to get a little bit basic, except for the halides. The halides are not basic at all, but that's a problem. Your nucleophile needs to attack something, not deprotonate something. But these are the good nucleophiles that we'll encounter in, as we discuss, SN2 reactions.